Is OpenAI about to launch a new device? Stay tuned for my thoughts on all the rumors surrounding Jony Ive and Sam Altman's collaboration and what impact this new device could have on OpenAI and ChatGPT's product strategy. And as always, if you enjoy the channel, hit the subscribe and the like button. So according to reports this week, OpenAI is said to have discussed acquiring the AI hardware startup that former Apple design lead Jony Ive is building with OpenAI CEO Sam Altman. And according to the information, OpenAI could pay around $500 million for the company called IO Products. So Ive left Apple back in 2019 to start his own design firm called Love From. And it was confirmed that he was working with Altman on the hardware startup last year. The information's report notes that OpenAI may end up partnering with instead of acquiring IO Products, which currently has a small team that includes former Apple designers Tang Tan and Evans Hanke. IO Products has reportedly been working on various different concepts of AI-enabled devices, including smart home gadgets. So this is what The Verge had to say about this. They say that Sam Altman and Jony Ive's AI project could involve a screenless device, so something like a phone-like product without a screen, as well as AI-enabled household devices. But is this a good idea? Should OpenAI really start to build hardware? And how does this fit into its overall product strategy? So at the moment, ChatGPT is the undisputed leader of AI assistants, with over 400 million weekly active users. A new analysis suggests that this is more than twice the amount of its closest competitors. And the general consensus right now seems to be that as the differences between each of the models shrinks and models themselves become commodities, then it's the application or product layer that is built on top of these models that will give companies the opportunity to truly differentiate themselves. In OpenAI's case, they've done a pretty good job so far of building a series of different products on top of their models. But if competitors' hardware becomes more integrated with their AI assistants, could this potentially stifle OpenAI's growth? So if you think about it, Amazon's Alexa is already in the homes of hundreds of millions of users. Google has a series of its own home devices, and we know from reports that Google is phasing out its own AI assistant across many of its devices and replacing it with Gemini. Apple's, of course, got the devices, but they don't have the assistant and they may not catch up until 2027. Microsoft has its own series of hardware with Surface products and other hardware, and it's rumored to be decoupling itself from OpenAI's technology. And Perplexity is known for just building just about anything, so whether that's coffee, browsers, phone integrations with Deutsche Telekom and a bunch of others. So in this sense, OpenAI is actually a little bit behind, and its lack of physical footprint could have an impact on its ability to sustain its early advantages. If users inevitably build direct relationships with their companions, then it probably makes sense for users to want them to continue their conversations across multiple devices. And as we've seen in recent weeks, voice mode capabilities are just getting better and better. So perhaps OpenAI is imagining a future here where users build a long-lasting, deep relationship with their AI assistants. And naturally, this makes sense that you'd want that relationship to continue across multiple different modalities. So imagine a future where you start a conversation on ChatGPT on your laptop, you pick it up with your voice assistant on your phone, and then when you get home, you continue that conversation whilst you're cooking your dinner. But building hardware doesn't come without risks, and I'm not entirely sure that this would be a good thing for OpenAI. It goes without saying that the past year has been littered with recent failures in this AI hardware space. The most high profile of these is probably Humane's AI Pin, which failed for a number of different reasons, but perhaps the most important one was its price. It was $699, plus the additional $24 a month for a monthly subscription fee. Now, people really didn't want to have to pay this additional subscription fee, but if OpenAI was to launch its own hardware device, then since users are already paying a subscription fee, then it would just be the additional costs for hardware. So perhaps OpenAI could avoid some of those issues that plagued the AI Pin with their own device. But there's also just this issue of carrying another device. Do people really want to carry their phones, plus their Apple Watches and the accessories for their phones, as well as another assistant that just lets them interact with AI? I'm not sure about that. Other products that failed recently include the Rabbit. Plus, there have been a bunch of new pieces of hardware, such as the Friend Pendant and the Limitless Pendant. Both of these take a slightly different approach to this segment, which is where they record everything that you say and do throughout the day and then create transcripts that can be searched upon to discover insights about your own behavior. There is a strategic opportunity here for OpenAI, but it does come with a lot of risks. If OpenAI's hardware fails, this could potentially have a seriously negative impact on the company and its prospects for raising further investment. It goes without saying that there are actually plenty of people who will want the company to fail, including artists who say that OpenAI's training models have stolen copyrighted works, and a certain Elon Musk who is suing the company for its transition into a for-profit. OpenAI is also a loss-making company, so it recently raised an additional $40 billion at a $500 billion valuation, but Amazon placed its bet that it could sell Alexa devices at a loss and recoup the money in future purchases, a hypothesis that later turned out to be false. Not to mention the word that everyone is talking about right now, which is tariffs. In the current economic climate, why would anybody want to produce hardware, knowing that the supply chains are likely to be impacted by the tariffs that have currently been imposed by the US administration? In a piece this week over on the Wall Street Journal, they showed this diagram, which shows us that the cost of producing an iPhone 16 Pro is likely to grow from the pre-tariff total of $549 up to a new post-tariff total of $846. Unless OpenAI is planning to manufacture the entire device in the US, then it doesn't really make much sense to launch a new piece of hardware right now. But let's put all of that aside for a second, and let's imagine that they do go ahead and build this new device. Jony Ive is a legendary product designer with an astonishing track record. So this guy is responsible for designs like the legendary iMac G3 back in 1998, the iPod, the iPhone, the iPad, and the Apple Watch, just to name a few. We won't mention some of the less desirable products that he designed, including the hockey puck mouse, the Apple Newton message pad, and the 2016 MacBook with its notoriously bad butterfly keyboard design. But let's imagine that Ive takes all of his previous experience and success stories and puts these into action for a new OpenAI device. What might this new device look like? Well, who best to ask this question to than ChatGPT? So I've given ChatGPT all of the information regarding Ive's previous history in terms of the products he's designed. And this is what it says OpenAI's device might look like. So what do you think? If you were in a product meeting deciding whether to build this, would it be a go or no go? And if OpenAI did build a device like this, which is designed to help you spend less time on your phone and more time interacting with your AI assistant, would you actually use it? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one.